teve jeito. X-ray. We see this space between the bones. cartridge looks transfer. So, but not your X-ray shows this problem, yeah? Nowadays they fulfill endoscopic examination in the cartridge. That's why we'll see in it just changes for the cartridge. What are the changes? First of all, cartilage loses protoglycans. Protoglycans, the substances which contribute to the matrix of the cartilage, which make it transparent, elastic, and it becomes fragile afterwards. Dry and fragile. What are the morphological changes? Pay attention to the surface of the cartilage. One can see tangential lesions of the cartilage, superficial lesions. These lesions are named flaking of the cartilage, flaking of the cartilage. Superficial disorders, they are lesions, flaking. And these parts, small parts, just discharge from the surface, detach from the surface, and move into within the synovial fluid. You know, fluid is there in this joint, yeah? And sometimes they appear between the ligamentous and the joint. It is very clear. For the person, it looks like anything just cuts something. They name this moment joint mouse. Like mouse bites. This is the particle separated from the cartilage. Besides superficial lesions, one can see vertical fissures. Vertical fissures is more advanced change. This fissure officially is named fibrillation of the cartilage. More prominent problem which destroys cartilage completely up to bone, which is of bright pink. Cartilage gradually disappears, destroys, and bone becomes naked. One can see this picture, no cartilage, and as bone compress each other without amortization, yeah? They appear, so these grooves or fissures on the surface. Grooves of fissures on the surface. Lesions of the bone now. Bone is gradually destroyed. In patients with advanced problem, one can hear how bones move up on each other, yeah? Because if cartilage is present, no sounds. If bones move, then looks like sounds just the heart tissue. So, after bones already are removed, starts reaction of the hips. It is compressed because you see, here it is straight, then it becomes different, yeah? Also compression occurs, as you can see. And it is inflamed. Inflammation of the hips is painful. The joint becomes swollen, red, hot in touch. Very painful, and patients go to see the doctor. But it is third stage. It should be treated before. There are certain medicines, there are certain least they become patients, become more strong because severe pain and so on. Now we get to rheumatoid arthritis, which is an arthritis. Remember, we discussed osteoarthritis, now rheumatoid. It is mostly inflammatory. This is the variant of rheumatic disease. Remember what is rheumatic disease? It is general inflammation of the connective tissue. General inflammation of the connective tissue. Here mostly in joints. What is the problem? Still, they don't know exactly the problem. They only know that in this pathology is causing. So, what are the problems there? Well, to see it a moment, that opposite to osteoarthritis, in rheumatoid arthritis, small joints are. Do you see anything?
Yes.
So, small joints are involved. And process starts from capsule towards cartilage, then to brain. Opposite starts, yeah, from capsule. Capsule, well, cartilage. Capsule, cartilage, well. So, immune complexes, antibodies, plus they think of viruses as well. They disturb cancer. What happens to inflammation? It becomes thickened. It becomes thickened, swollen. There is edema there and infiltration by lymphocytes. Edema and multiple lymphocytes. You see them in the picture. Inflammation gets chronic. And you know, any chronic inflammation leads to what? To abundant connective tissue development. To fibrosis. So, it starts growth of young connective tissue, regulation tissue, towards the space between the bones, inside of the joint. We name this growth fundus or myxia. Fundus or myxia.
Connective tissue?
Fundus, this granulation. Young connective tissue is granulation tissue, yeah? And when it grows, it is named fundus. So, fundus continuously grows and covers cartilage. Cartilage is here, you understand, yeah? It covers cartilage, fundus covers cartilage, and cartilage can't get nutrients from synovial. You know how cartilage is from. Because there are no vessels in the cartilage, yeah? Every diffusely from synovial fluid. Now it is separated from fluid. And what happens? Of course, degeneration. Of course, degeneration. They appear oozorean in the cartilage lesions. Oozorean. In the cartilage, and fundus growth is inside of this oozorea as well. What happens at least? The ends of bones adhere to each other, and the joint becomes moveless. We name this ankylosis. suffers from. Young people, mostly young adults, mostly females, the ratio females to males 4 to 1. This disease leads to invalidization. That's why we treat in the rheumatology departments in our regional hospitals. The disease is mostly treated by hormones to lower inflammation, to lower immune reactions. So, where does it develop? As we said, small joints, interphalangeal joints, or metacarpophalangeal joints, interphalangeal or metacarpophalangeal, and symmetric, mostly symmetric. The changes there are irreversible. This is the result, deformity of the joints, hands here. Even feet can be also destroyed. Now, another disease is named ankylosing spondylitis. Pay attention. There are two types of inflammatory diseases. The previous one, this one, which we name rheumatoid arthritis, is named seropositive. Seropositive means rheumatoid factor is present. Rheumatoid factor, you know from your home. Yeah? Well, antibodies to excess present or improved. So, seropositive. For example, you suppose rheumatoid arthritis, cheek blood. If it is seropositive, surely the diagnosis is clear. But the disease we see now is seronegative. Who suffers? Now males. The essence of the disease. Problems of the ligamenta apparatus of the vertebral column. Problems of the ligamenta apparatus of the vertebral column. What happens to you see? You know that bones or vertebrae have joints, yeah? And ligamenta come from each vertebral body to another, yeah? Small ligamenta, big ones as well, longitudinal, you know. What happens in the disease? Inflammation develops in the places of incision of ligamenta to vertebra. Inflammation of the places of adhesion of ligamenta to vertebra. What does it mean, this inflammation? About 20 years later, whales start suffering from back pains. Very painful to sleep long time. They prefer to stay or to lay down. Then, of course, it limits movements in the body. In time. Either it is limited pain and that's all, but some of them get progression. And all ligaments undergo calcification. And they see that vertebral column becomes bamboo-like. You saw better bamboo, yeah? How does it look? Not chain by chain, yeah? But completely the same for the certain position. That's all. They can't see, they can't move. They just at a certain position. Because column is calcified like stone. This is the essence of the process. We have one more seromagnetic disease, which is named Reuter's syndrome. Males as well.
Interesting material que pedia, muito
bom. This spelling can differ because it is French investigator who described the disease, Reuter's disease. Sometimes they put all here. It depends. You will see the essence of the disease. Inflammation of joints, beginning from big ones towards small ones. Besides joints involvement is also urethritis. What is it?
Inflammation of urethra.
Conjunctivitis.
Inflammation of the eyes.
Maybe even dry eye, dry mouth, chagrin syndrome. So the problem is infection. Infection of the urinary genital tract. Infection by uroplasma, chlamydia, and syphilis. Usually young people suffer. And they treat joints, but what should be treated? Infection. That's for the difference. If you see joints involved in males progress and not compatible with age, yeah? Ask, does this patient have urethritis? Urethritis and conjunctivitis, and what should be treated? Post-infection, this disease destroys joints and the couple. That's why we will return to it. You will read yourself, but remember that top of the male for fibrous tissue, yeah, are all this. Gout is what? Nuclear proteins metabolism disorder. I will see mixed degeneration, and you will read from the last one. Only briefly, because nowadays is something parathyroid osteodystrophy. Parathyroid osteodystrophy. According to the name, where is the cause in parathyroid osteodystrophy? Yeah? Remember, we touched this problem. The para hormone takes calcium. Bones become porotic, multiple cavities, porotic, soft. Even cysts develop inside of bones cavities. Cysts develop in bones. Sometimes bone is replaced by fibrous tissue, like scar. Either cyst or fibrosis. Plus, vessels can be destroyed and hemorrhages develop. Hemorrhages inside of the cyst. And this mass of blood becomes brown. Why? Hemocyanin. Yeah, mm-hmm. You see brown color here. They are named chocolate cysts of parathyroid osteodystrophy. They are well seen on X-ray. Like cysts, if they take syringe and take biopsy, they see hemocyanin of blood. What is to be done? Normalize national treasure. Maybe I don't know what you are doing.